Hello everybody and welcome once again to Running Red, that hardcore questing mod back from Gideon Seymour. Now, I have managed to go into the dream world and get some disturbed cotton. In fact, I've got enough disturbed cotton to make the twisted, I think it's a twisted twine. If I open up this chest here, I've got all the things I need. Now for the Dreamweaver of Nightmares, let's put those down there, and I'm going to keep these in order so I know which way they go, and we shall make this Dreamweaver of Nightmares contraption. And what you get is this, I need something actually, Reek of Misfortune, take one of those, a string, I don't think there's a string in that chest, let's just quick sort it, because I don't need that anymore, but I've also got quite a lot of mandrakes, quite a lot of belladonna. I've been sort of growing those in the off camera, as it were, one string and some disturbed cotton. It's quite hard to get the disturbed cotton, and I think we'll show you that in a second. So in the spinning wheel we'll put one string, actually it's not there, it goes in here, so let's put this four disturbed cotton in at the moment, and Reek of Misfortune, and let's have a look at this. You see when it stops animating, it doesn't take very long, we shall have another disturbed cotton. Right, here we go. One tormented twine, sorry. So now, I'll put that away, I don't need that anymore. I've actually got a sleeping bag as well. So let's go and make this Dreamweaver of Nightmares. So we need Diamond Vapor, Splash Potion of Night Vision, three tormented twines and two feathers should give me the Dreamweaver of Nightmares. And what's supposed to happen is if I put that beside my bed or near to where I go to sleep, we should, and this is should, not, well, 50% chance. I'm going to dig up the bag from here actually, and I'm going to put it around here somewhere else. Let's say here's a good place, better with an axe, wouldn't I? And let's put that torch down here, say. So let's put a bed here, it's probably a good place. Oops, wrong one. There we go. And now I need one to put on top of that, this, and I can't do that at the moment. Let's have a quick look. I need some slabs, because all blocks of wood. Actually, I've got a block of wood, I'll use that one. Go on the bed here and dig up this slab, and yes, I'll do actually. And I can put this slab on top of that slab, and I can put this block of wood here instead, and we can put a torch on top of put a torch say here, and I can put the Dreamweaver Nightmares here. And when I go to sleep, it's supposed to have a 50% chance of catching the nightmares. Well, last time that didn't work. In fact, let's quickly check the quest book, because I haven't done that. I did this one, it's a repeatable quest, it keeps happening time and time again. Oops, one claim, let's open that again. Still got it. Okay, claim reward. Diamond and a bag, reward bag. Oh, I got a lava crystal. Quite good. So let's put the diamond in here, the lava crystal over here in this chest, and we've got plenty of lava crystals now. Four. Let's throw away the aubries in the trash can, because we don't need any more aubries, and put that back here. Let's have a look. Let's have a look at the quest book, because we completed the quest. Actually, in fact, I've completed more than one quest. I've completed two. I've even got one here. Let's open this. And here we've got Running White. And Running White is created by creating a bottle of milk. And this one here, I've got to go and get some oak planks. I should have some of those around. I just put one up on the top, didn't I? Oak planks. Oh, that's in there. Let's just take some oak wood and put that in the sawmill. Maybe there's some already in there. It goes very fast anyway. And up here I should get some oak planks. There we are. We need one. So let's manually detect that. Select this task manual submit. Claim the reward. So I've got another 5 hearts. Another 5 lives in effect. So now we've completed 4 of those. Another one of those is supposed to be getting this contraption here, but I can't seem to find a way to get this to work. I don't know what's wrong. Let's just take it again. I think I can use a pickaxe to pick this up. Yes. In fact, it's fully charged, and I think the one I need is uncharged. Anyway, I'll leave it here for the time being. So, go back to the quest book again, and now we're going to the demolition lovers, which is the one we've got. So this is the one we've created. This, and actually it's a repeatable quest, and it gets 30 ice needles and 30 bruises sleeping, which is great. So let's now try and have a dream. Oh, there are a few other things I'd like to show you before I do that. If I fly up here, instead of having these collection points under, I created this contraption, which was the Ritual of Zephyr. I'm not sure exactly. Let me just have a quick look. I don't think I've got it in here. No, I haven't. That's my building chest. I'm not doing any more bee stuff on camera. I've been very busy doing it. The reason for that is I don't think it's part of the quest, really. So we need the Ritual Diviner. Here we are. Oh, there it is. In fact, it's actually got it. So it's the Call of the Zephyr, and that's the one. With the Call of the Zephyr, you can basically pick up everything in a 10x10, well, 21x21, 10 up, 10 across from the Master Ritual Stone, which is here. And as you can see, it's collecting all of the droppings from the mobs. They're coming down here, going past the sorting chests here, and ending up most of them in the trash can these days. But this chest picks up a few bits and pieces, as you can see. Plenty of slime balls, plenty of seeds, creeper plant seeds, plenty of zombie brains and whatever else. And I added in here a chest for string, and a chest here for ender pearls. So they're both nearly full. And I've extended the base out here in order to do some circle magic in witchery. As you can see, this is now a reasonably good area for doing circle magic. It needs to be, I think, maximum is 15 by 15. But I don't have with me my measure. Let's have a quick measure of that. I think at the moment it's only 11 by 11. The measure should be in here. Okay, let's take the food out of there. And also I should see what my next quest is as well. So at the moment, if I measure this point, say, from here, which could be an outer point. Not a stick. Try that again. Oh, it's not appearing, is it? So say here, which is 12 metres. So that's 15 metres. That's actually big enough for the circle magic. So if I put that back here, oh, that's how it worked. Really strange. And this point here is 7 meters. Yes, here. So let's put a torch down here. In fact, let's put a set of torches down here. Then we know where the middle of the circle magic is. We've got plenty of torches, and they're pretty easy to make anyway, so it's no big deal. In fact, I probably don't need any more slime balls either. I probably can get rid of this. But I did actually have quite a successful time with my bees. I will show you, even though I'm not going to do any more bee stuff here, If I look here, I built an indexer and put loads of beads in it. You have to press shift click to get beads into here. If I now sort by type, you'll see I've got quite a few princesses. Drag this down a bit. Quite a lot of rocky princesses and quite a lot of forest drones, princesses. Most of the forest ones are actually ignoble. Bit weird, don't ask me why. And they were coming from this position here, up here. And here I've been crossbreeding, and now I've got industrious princesses and so on and so forth. I've also got three pollens. Now the pollen is also getting put into this chest here, so now I've got 10 pollen and 21 royal jelly, which can be used for building alvary blocks. In fact, this particular chest here has got an imperial queen, and this has the beatific effect. And if I just stand here for a few seconds, have a look, E, what I should get is regen for about 4 seconds of regen every. Oh, of course, it's night time. That's why actually I've got a sleeping bag. If I sleep here now, quickly, sleep over that night. Doesn't take very long, fortunately. Here we go. Now I stand here and press E, you'll see what happens. I should put that up. There we go. Oh, didn't show me. Regeneration. So it happens every once in a while for 4 seconds. So that's quite useful. But that's no more bee stuff in this episode, in this series, I don't think. I was hoping to find some hives, and I did actually go around and build some more little islands. One of the islands was here. Turn off the jetpack. And this one here was just a little bit underneath a slime island. There are slime islands in this mod pack, and I can harvest these and take them back again, but I'm not going to bother. They also need a chunk loader, so a chicken chunk loader is good. There's one here, there's another one which was in desert biome. Actually, that was a desert biome. This biome here is let's have a look. This is a desert biome. So I was hoping for some desert hives, but no chance so far. And the third one was over here, and this is actually just on top of a witch's hut, because it was a good place to fly around from. All I was doing was just flying around, and that was a slow click. And looking for a jungle biome. This is plains. I didn't find one yet. Oops, what happened there? Got stuck, that's a bit weird. Oh, no, not really. Okay, but what I would like to do is to do some dreaming with you and see if, with a bit of luck, we'll either get nightmares or dreams. So for when that paints in, okay. So if I'm standing by here, what happens is everything I've got on me except for icy needles and disturbed wispy cotton and a few other things will actually not come with me. These will come with me, and the reason you want those is so you can wake up. So here we go. So here's the little island, but unfortunately the nightmare is there, so you can hear him. What I did is I burrowed up somewhere, but don't ask me where I burrowed up. I just kept on burrowing up. I did actually manage to get a pickaxe. And what happens is this guy chases you, so you've got to get out of the way as quickly as possible. I see now I reach stone. So I can't get past the stone unless... You see, what I have here are things that I've got on me. Unless I can make something. And I've only got one piece of wood. So I'll tell you what we'll do. First of all, try and get some more wood. I don't have an axe or anything, just hands and potions. I'll do that one. I'll pick it up. And then we can build a crafting. Right, we've got enough now for crafting. Block, let's just quickly make a crafting block. See, completely naked as well, that doesn't help very much either. I put the crafting block down, say, here. Let's see if we can craft quickly a stone pickaxe or something. Oh, so I managed to get a stone pickaxe, great. And what you do is you just keep going up here and dig. I think that was actually iron. Of course, stone pickaxe won't last very long. Now I can't see a thing. What have we got with us? Any coal yet? No. Maybe if I could find a block of coal, we'd be okay. What's that over there? Just stone, I think. And what you do is you keep going up. And you have to watch out for water. In fact, you can see it on the map. There, I'm actually going towards some water. A pool of water. I need to cut the one above my head. Let's have a quick look. Have we got any stone with us so far? No. It's a bit dark. I'm sorry. It's dark for me too, by the way. There we go. Some coal. Right, now with that coal, we can quickly make some torches. Oh, I've got torches already. Honestly. Didn't see them. I've got them in my inventory. So you can then put a torch down here. Great. So, let's keep going. And when I was first did this, the first thing I actually found was was an iron pickaxe in one of these chests. Looks like there's water just ahead of me. Maybe I should turn. You end up with quite a lot of cobblestone, of course. What have we got here? Infused stone. And sand. That could be a bad sign. Let's see if we can dig away the sand here. Oops, what's we got there? This is a nightmare. And I don't think we could attack the nightmare. Oh, we can actually. Kill the nightmare this time. Last time I couldn't kill the nightmare. Oh, brilliant, just broke me. I'm not sure what the attack damage of this one is. 74. See, I have no food either, so I can't do any health. 68. And we're quite near the beach when we come out of here. Hard work killing this thing, isn't it? Oh, I just broke on that as well. Brilliant. No. Right, let's quickly go back and make ourselves a sword. Using stone. In fact, I probably should make two swords, shouldn't I? Because then when one breaks, it breaks. And we can also make another pickaxe. That would be a good idea as well. Stone pickaxes don't last very long. And eventually I can make a chest. Let's get the chest out of the way. Oh, I'm going to wake up in a second now. Get out of the way. He's obviously following me. It's another nightmare. This one's not the same one. So I don't have much chance I'll be woken up. Right, that's it. So, you basically keep doing this until you actually succeed in getting away from them. Oh, where am I now? I'm not woken up in the same place at all as the previous time. Oh well. Let's put the pickaxe in. That gravel. Oh, that's gravel. I was quite close to where I was before, by the looks of it, but not exactly in the same place. Just looking at the map, and I'm going actually in the wrong direction from where I was last time. Let's go across here. Oops, it's attacking me again. Or maybe not. Oops. Gravel. Well, gravel's useful. Of course you get flint, but plenty more gravel up here. Copper. And we keep going up. Prefer not to be in the gravelly bit, but we are. I've got no choice. And every time you wake up, or go back, have the dream, it's a recurring dream type dream, you don't lose your inventory that you've got from the previous time. Just stand back one here. Let's get a torch up here. See what we're doing. At least a little bit. How high am I now? 58. So I've got to get up to about 60. I've got a shovel either, never mind. But there doesn't look like there's anything under here. Again, it's too dark, put a torch down. You can actually hear skeletons above me, so I am still in a nightmare. Fortunately, I just don't know how many times I've got to do this before I actually get a dream. It's supposed to be 50%. And then when you've got a dream, you can get your wispy cotton. Best way to do that, let's just put down another torch here. No food, that's the other problem. Oops, there he is. We want to basically get away from him if we can. But he's a bit of a pain. Yes. So that's that sound. Let's just move the bed out of the way, actually, and put it here. You see, the inventory changes completely. The only thing you can take with you is wispy cotton and icy needles, if I didn't say that already. Let's have another dream. You've come out now in a completely different spot than I did last time. At least we've got some torches. Let's put one of these down straight away. Let's see what's going on. Where are we? Put some more torches down here. I have a chance of seeing where I was. This looks like Ceratus Quartz iron. So that's good. Let's take these. Three. And it would pull, what's this up here? Osmian ore. Never seen that before, actually, any mod pack I've played. Because it's the first time I've been had a mod pack with osmian in it. Right, can we make quickly a... Actually, maybe I'm lucky this time. Aluminium ore. That's going down there, blocked. We could try blocking off some of these passages. Let's do that. I've probably got absolutely stacks of stuff in here, but not very much wood. Let's see if we block those off there. I don't think we're in nightmare world. I think we're in a dream world now. Let's get past here. There we go. spider. Maybe we can kill the cape spider before he kills us. It's the only chance I've got, really. And I've only got... I've still got a sword. I get to it, that is. Cut that. Nuisance. There we are. Right, got it. Right, I wanted to get this water blocked off, didn't I? And that's coming from over here. Where can we block that off? Ugh. Put one down here. Oops, a skeleton shooting me out. Let's get out of the way quickly. Oh, here we are. Here's my old... I'll be able to get that skeleton before he sees us. Going to come. Oh no, he's stuck, isn't he? What we can do, of course, now, if I can get to this, is to quickly craft a furnace. Get that in there, can't get anywhere else. And beside this, we could put a furnace down. Oh, this thing's getting mad. Oh, good. That doesn't happen every day. Two skeletons shooting each other. So now I've got this alley ore and some coal. Let's get that in there. Two skeletons shooting each other. Isn't that good? Oops. Not for long enough. What's my health like? Not too bad at the moment. Let's go and pick up some more of these. The spider down there I've seen. Ooh, plenty. Obviously the important things here is to get some iron armour and maybe just a copper armour wouldn't be too bad. I tried to make some copper weapons but that didn't work. If I can get rid of this guy. That could have killed or woken up, as it were, the correct term, I suppose. Oops. There's another spider down here, that's also bad. Maybe we can get him. Yes, we did. Also, we can put a torch down here. I'm running out of torches. There's a zombie tied up in a spider nest. There's a raw spider want to get a sword out. Oh, there's a spider spawner. We want to keep away from that where possible, I think. There's a zombie with some armor. And I've got an armour, so let's put this armour on. Won't last very long, but it's better than nothing. The next thing I need to do is make a chest. So I need some more wood. Let's just use this sapling. Sapling, where did that come from? Oops. Now, can I get out of here? I've actually got nothing I can do at the moment. I'm a bit stuck. Oops, that was close. Let's see if I can get out of here somewhere in one of my passages. Ah, here we go. And here was my... Ah, this is my original way out. I've got 5 coal in there. Let's just shove these into here and get some more iron. Let's see if I reckon it's not a nightmare now, so I reckon it's daytime. So we should be not have so many mobs around. In fact, the best thing to do is to put a torch down where I've just come out of, isn't it? Wherever that is. Lost it already. There's a pig. Let's chase after this pig. Food is always important, especially at the moment. What have I got here? Get rid of the zombie flesh, don't want that. Don't want these bones. Well, maybe we do. Let's craft those like that. Let's get back into that cave if it's possible. Trouble is, I just don't know where I came out of. I was just going to put a torch down where I came out of, and then we could see. Oh, this is a different passage. There's some coal here, that's good, so we can dig up this coal. Oh. This is actually my first non-nightmare in the dream world, so that's great. So now what I want to do, so take this opportunity to get as much stuff as I can. Real Minecraft stuff, and it's all sort of vanilla Minecraft at the moment. I really do need some wood, so let's get some wood. As a chicken, have I got any capacity here? No. But I would like to make a chest first. Let's make a chest first. Probably not the best thing. Let's just use a punch it. What I'd like to do is to find some wispy cotton. Now, if this video goes on too long, I'll just stop it. You'll see what I'm doing. Anyway, it's just sort of ordinary Minecraft beginning stuff. Oh, and I've got too much stuff. Let's get rid of something I don't want. Cotton seeds, best plant seeds. Okay, I probably don't need those for the time being. Okay, and they actually planted. Ah, that's actually a pain because I cannot do it here, so that's a problem. Because you notice that was not an apple good. Let's get rid of this cotton seed and eat the apple. That means I've got to go back into the mine to get wood. I can't think of any other way of getting it. Here we have some copper gravel ore. That means I don't really have much choice, does it? Tell you what I will do though. There's a dead zombie there. Oh, so it's full of dirt, okay. We can have a look around now and see if we can get some wispy cotton, because with wispy cotton we can plant it. And if I can find anywhere near to where I was. That's great. Oops. Big hole there. We'll go down there for the time being. Some stone. This is just like some food. Chickens are quite good for food as well. Oh, I have to get rid of something else. That one. This should be. Yes, good. Chicken. Sounds like a spider. What I want to do is go towards the water. What's this over here? Oh, okay. Just not rendered in yet. Wait a second or two. That looks like water over there, so oh no, I can see it on the map. Okay, we walk this way, I think. Wait for it to render in. I do not like it not rendering in. The video is for 35 minutes now, so that's a... It's obviously a winter biome. And here we have some water. And what I did last time was I swam around the coast until I found some disturbed wispy cotton, but of course in a nightmare it's disturbed cotton. So if I can find some wispy cotton now, you swim it, walk over the ice. There's a cow. Also good food supply. But actually we cannot do that yet, can we? We don't have another 4 planks. I used them up in the wrong place. Oil. This looks like magical forest. Are we in magical forest? Yes, we are. You can tell by the green. Green are the magical. Ah, here we go. What's this? Wispy cotton. Fantastic. See? Oh, I need to get rid of some, make some space. Let's throw those away. Okay. Right, now I've got the wispy cotton. You can actually plant it. That's just one hit, it's very straightforward. Is there any more wispy cotton around here? This tree. This is obviously not, this looks more like... What biome are we in now? Tiger. The idea is you just got to go around to get some wispy cotton. So, I shall do that and say cheerio for now and see you next time. Ooh, what's this thing here? Bye for now.